On this episode of UTR, it's our Tips of the Fingers episode, where we wander across the top of Michigan's mitten. We'll show you some kickback cabins on Lake Huron, an Italian restaurant the locals love, and we'll fly through the trees near Mackinaw. Then we'll take you to a dam-side inn, a little town with a good heart, and a state park that will blow your natural mind. Get ready to explore the cool people, places, and things that make Michigan a great place to be.
Under the Radar Michigan is brought to you in part by the Michigan State Housing Development Authority, investing in people, places, and partnerships to help transform Michigan and the Michigan economy. In cities, towns, and neighborhoods, people are building better places to live and better communities.
I've been around the world, but there's one place I keep coming back to. And the more I explore, the more I realize it's the place to be. I'm Tom Dalton, and this is Under the Radar Michigan. You know, we love this part of Michigan up here so much, we're gonna do a whole show about it. And we're calling it the Tips of the Fingers Special. Pretty clever, huh?
We headed north up Michigan's index finger in search of a great place to stay and a good hot meal. And since this is Michigan, we had no problem finding both.
Just 7 miles north of Rogers City, we found a place that's so relaxing, it'll lower your blood pressure in 3, 2, 1, ah.
If you're looking for laid-back log cabin luxury, the Manitou Shores Resort is the place to kick back and unwind. It's quiet, secluded, and every night the waves rolling in off of Lake Huron are your lullaby. Bruce Grant is the owner-operator, and he loves making sure that you get just what you want out of this relaxing experience.
I don't know if you go on the web or not much, but if you read the reviews on your place, people are saying really nice things about you and this place.
Well, we're glad to hear that, and but you got to keep in mind, we have some pretty wonderful customers. We've been here 28 years. We spent 2 years of that time tearing everything down and rebuilding it. But we have people who have been coming here for 25 years straight.
You know what I love about this part of the state, the northeast part of Michigan, is it's just so laid back and relaxing.
Well, once you get here, it takes a while to slow down.
Yeah.
And when I used to come here as a vacationer, I was like, God, I can't get anybody going and get anything done around here. And now, to go downstate and drive or get in the traffic, I don't even like to go south of Bay City anymore. It scares you to death.
How long have you owned these cabins?
This is our 29th year.
Oh, so you've been up here a while.
But it wasn't, I mean, the land was here where these big cabins are, were 5 real small log cabins.
Well, some people hear log cabin and they think, I'm not staying in a log cabin, but when I walked in there, that place is nicer than my house. I mean, these are beautiful cabins inside.
Well, yeah, they're the modern style log cabins. Yeah.
Rustic outside, inside, all the amenities.
Exactly, exactly. But the comfort of being up north.
Now, you were telling me when I called you on the phone about there's a waterfall near here, Akiak?
Akiak Falls, and it's beautiful. The state bought it in the early 30s, and it was a devastating place because all the trees had been cut down and, you know, it was timbered. And to look at it today from the pictures when the state took it over, then last year, they put a tremendous amount of money into bringing it up to par. And it is just something to see. They've rock slabbed everything.
And it's the largest waterfall in the Lower Peninsula?
In the Lower Peninsula. Totally owned by the state. It's beautiful.
And a lot of people don't realize that this side of the state, there are so much to do. There's shipwrecks you can explore.
Right here, there's 40 foot of water. A lot of people snorkel the Fay right off the 40 Mile Point Lighthouse. In fact, part of the wreck is laying on the beach, but the pilot house and a lot of the rest of it is in 40 feet of water. It's marked, and they just swim out there and snorkel.
There's also bike trails, there's mushroom hunting, there's charter fishing here, there's
exactly.
Tons of stuff to do here. So you can relax, but if you don't want to relax, there's tons to do.
A lot of our customers kind of use this as a wheel. They want to rest, but they still want to do stuff, or they do family things that just kind of lay back and enjoy themselves.
What's the most rewarding thing about what you do here?
Oh, just being here, the serenity, the peace and quiet. The wages aren't that great, but everything that goes with it is far superior.
Right, it's the quality of life.
Exactly. That's exactly why you live in Northern Michigan.
Last question, is there a curfew tonight for us?
No. No, come and go as you want. If you make too much noise, I'll come and quiet you down.
You heard him, guys. We gotta behave.
Michigan Sunrise Site is an awesome place to get away from it all and still have all kinds of great things to do. And the Manitou Shores Resort is a great place to start. Now, how about that hot meal?
You're gonna love this. We found a restaurant that's so nice, it's two restaurants in one.
Just 8 miles farther north on US 23 in the town of Millersburg, we found a restaurant that's the Chuck Wagon by day and Rosa's Squeeze In by night. Gary, Joanne, and their son Jeff Yacklin are continuing the Rosa's tradition by bringing a little bit of Italy to the Sunrise Side.
Sorry I'm dressed so casual, but I thought I was going to the Chuck Wagon. But I guess I'm at Rosa's.
This is Rosa's Squeeze In. Yes, it is. And it's very elite, as you can tell.
Well, this place is two different restaurants. Explain.
One building, two restaurants. Started out as a breakfast and lunch restaurant. That's where the Chuck Wagon's located now. Then it sold to a couple that came up from Chicago. And they decided they wanted to do the Italian thing. So they changed that little restaurant, that's now the Chuck Wagon, to Rosa's Squeeze In.
So how far back do these recipes go?
I'd say maybe 15 years, you know.
It's a great place to come with my family and friends and good food and close to home.
This is a hidden gem.
It's not only the wonderful food, it's the atmosphere and the experience of the whole night. It's not just a dinner out, it's the whole evening.
What do you think about Gary and Joanne? What do you think about
them? Wonderful, wonderful owners. They are a joy to come in here and talk to in the evenings when we come in to dine.
Joanne is here every day. Gary's here every night talking to people. I love the family feel, and the food is delicious.
You originally from this area?
No, I moved up from the Trenton Downriver area 40 years ago.
What brought you up here?
The north. Just the north, the beautiful Lake Huron, and I just fell in love with it, and it's just a wonderful area.
So the next time you pass through this part of the state and you're hungry, be sure to squeeze into Rosa's, or the Chuck Wagon,
or both.
The next morning, we headed northwest towards Mackinaw City in search of a place that would make us all feel like kids again. And you know us, we totally found it.
If you like Michigan history, nature, and adventure, you're watching the right TV show.
And that's because we're at the historic Mill Creek Discovery Park, a great family place where you can learn about Michigan's past, its wildlife, and a whole lot more. Jeff Dykehouse is the curator of natural history, which actually is just a fancy way of saying my new best friend for the day.
How long has this park been here?
It's opened up in 1984, so about 30 years now, almost 30 years.
Well, I'm sorry, it's my first time here.
Well, I'm glad you made it. Glad you finally got here.
Now, who owns this park?
It's part of the Mackinaw State Historic Parks. So it's one of the four parks that make up the Mackinaw State Historic Parks, including Mackinaw State Park and Colonial Michilimackinaw, the old Mackinaw Point Lighthouse in Mackinaw City.
And it's a historical experience. It's a whole bunch of experiences, but tell me about the historic part, like the sawmill.
Yeah, when the park was opened up 30 years ago, the major attraction was and still is the sawmill, the water-powered sawmill, which is a reconstruction water-powered sawmill, we think very similar to the one that was here over 200 years ago.
That dates back to the 1700s?
Yeah, about 1780s to 1790s when the first one was built.
And explain how it works. Yeah. I mean, what was the technology like back then?
Yeah, the original mill lasted for about 50 years, but before the mill was built, they had to cut lumber using a two-man pit saw. And then when the sawmill was built, that was a new technology of 200 years ago to provide lots of lumber that was needed on Mackinac Island during a building boom that took place about that time.
Now, this park is how many acres? It looks huge.
We have about 525 acres of property.
Right.
And it's mostly woods, you know, except for the historic area here, and we have about 3.5 miles of nature trails.
Next, Jeff took me to a place that would get me even higher on Michigan. It's part observation tower, part climbing wall, part scenic overlook, and a completely incredible experience.
Okay, Jeff, how many stairs did we just climb up here?
I think about 75 stairs.
Not
I think.
That's not bad. Yeah. This tower is incredible. How high are we?
We're about 50 feet off the ground, but that puts us about 150 feet above Lake Huron. So we are up very high.
This is a gazillion-dollar view. On a day like today, you can see the Upper Peninsula. The bridge is how many miles from here?
About 8 miles.
In the Mackinac Island, you can see the Grand Hotel. You can see the front porch.
It's a really a spectacular view.
And look at the different colors of the water.
Amazing. And this is all part of the park?
It's all part of the park.
This should be your office.
It should be my office. I'm open for that option.
Okay, I'll put a, where's the suggestion box?
I'll fill it out for you, just sign it so they know it doesn't come from me.
And now on to what really brought us here in the first place. If you're a thrill seeker and adventure hunter like me, you'll absolutely love this.
So the adventure tour is a different part of the park?
It's a nature hike in the park that allows us to look at the different layers of the forest. So rather than simply talk about the plants and animals we see along the ground, we're going to get up in the trees and talk about the difference between living up in the canopy versus the understory of the forest floor.
The tree canopy walk is something I'd heard about and was really excited to try. I can't even begin to tell you how cool it is walking this high off the forest floor.
So how high off the forest floor are we?
We're about 45 feet above the forest floor and the stream below us.
And how long is this this suspension bridge?
This bridge is about 150 feet long, I think.
This is outstanding. Now, like you said, now you know what it's like to be an eagle, to be a squirrel.
That's right.
To actually live in the trees.
That's right. Up here, everything's moving all the time, and you have to kind of pay attention where you're stepping, so you don't want to make that big tumble to the forest floor.
And I love how you're over this little river that runs into the pond.
It's a great view. You're surrounded by the trees, but you have running water down below you.
This is absolutely outstanding. Outstanding.
As part of the adventure tour, you also get to walk along beautiful forest pathways with a guide who shares vast amounts of information about this incredible natural landscape. And that's exactly what Jeff was doing, when suddenly, there it was. What I'd really been waiting for. The chance to zip line through the trees like an eagle in flight, over a cool mountain stream, to feel free and unencumbered, and express myself in a very noble and majestic way.
Thanks, Jeff.
You're welcome.
Because as usual, this will be easy.
But you know me, it didn't quite go that way.
Oh, gosh. Oh. Mommy!
So spend a day at the historic Mill Creek Adventure Park, and you'll find yourself learning, laughing, and launching yourself into the sky like the bird of your choice. Just do yourself a favor. Don't pick chicken like I did.
That was incredible. You really need to get up here and try and do this for yourself. Hold on a second. Hello? Oh, hi, Mom. No, I'm okay. I shouldn't have called. I'm sorry. I'm fine. Honestly, I'm fine. Yeah. Yeah. I'll be home tomorrow.
Hey, we're about to eat at a place that claims to have the best chicken in the world, which is pretty fitting since we have the best TV show in the world.
Oh, yeah.
About 20 miles south of the Mackinaw Bridge, somewhere between Brutus and Pelston, is the Dam Site Inn. And Ray and Pam East are one part of four generations that take care of this retro landmark.
Honestly, tell me, does Austin Powers come in here?
No, but he'd be welcome.
Oh my gosh, it's like sophisticated and groovy all at the same time.
Well, it was literally made, what you see was like the 50s dinner club, and they made it to look like that because that's what was refined and wonderful. And now, like you said, it's been so long that that's come back into fashion. But
oh, this is hip again.
Original.
Oh. What are the walls made out of? What's that material?
It's Naga hide from the Buick company. Both the original owner and his brother-in-law worked for Buick.
And just brought the material
this
up here?
It's all Naga hide, Karen Naga hide, the boomerang patterns. And
well, tell me about these funky chairs.
These are Eero Saarinen. He designed these. He worked for Charles Ames.
Well, he's famous. He designed the St. Louis Arch
and the JFK Airport.
And these are originals.
These are originals. Yep, they are absolute originals.
Well, I can't imagine anything chicer than a Saturday night sitting in here with a cocktail.
Yeah.
Plus, I like the padded bar just in case I've had one too many.
Yeah. Well, I figured before that happens, I better get out and chat with some of the Dam Site's loyal patrons.
What do you love about this restaurant?
I mean, the atmosphere, the food, I mean, just everything.
It's our favorite place to come. Love it.
I've been coming here for 30 years, and it reminds me of back in the 1950s, and I just love it. It's the greatest.
Have you eaten at the Haunted Table?
No.
There's a Haunted Table here, you know.
I did not know that.
It's over there. Who's making that noise?
It's this guy here.
So you moved up here from Royal Oak.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
What do you love about this area?
You know what? I love the open areas, the space, the wildlife, the trees, the clean air in the morning. I mean, this is the place to bring kids, and that's what I love.
Well, what brought us here is two things. One, this bar. I wanted to see this bar.
The bar is pretty fantastic, yeah.
The second thing is, I understand you have the best chicken in the world. Let's say it together. In the world. How is that even possible?
It is possible. And, you know, it's a very simple flour, salt, and pepper, and it's cooked in hot oil. And the original owner had some fryers made up. They're actually handmade for us for the operation, and they've been in use since 1960. So, and they're still used. We baby them, but there's nothing like it. It's pan-fried. It's not deep-fried. It's not pre-broasted and then, you know, pan-fried. It's amazing.
Well, sometimes the simplest recipes are the best.
Absolutely.
Another thing I heard about this place is anybody, not just TV show hosts, but anybody is allowed to just walk back in your kitchen.
Absolutely. It says right on our menu that our kitchen is open for your inspection. We're known for the cleanliness of our restaurant, and that's a real hallmark for us.
Well, I want to sit at the haunted table, and I want to have some of your best chicken
in the world.
Well, as promised, Pam sat us at the haunted table. But we were so hungry, and the food was so good, I don't remember ever seeing a ghost.
Hey, did you guys see that?
No.
So, if your dream restaurant has great fried chicken, a retro bar, a haunted table, an awesome family, and a damn right outside the back window, you're not dreaming. You're at the damn Side Inn. Last time we drove through the Tunnel of Trees, we blinked and totally missed Good Hart. But this time, we kept our eyes wide open. Good Hart is little, all right, but it's big on both quaintness and creativity. It's nestled halfway between Harbor Springs and Cross Village on Lakeshore Drive, and it's a favorite place for travelers to stop, shop, and find something tasty. In 1997, C.C. Bauer brought a hand-hewn 1840s log cabin all the way from Quebec to create primitive images. It's a great little up north boutique and tea room that's right in the heart of Good Hart.
Tell me a little bit about Good Hart.
All right, well, Good Hart has got a lot of charm, but we call it downtown Good Hart. And we are smack dab in the middle, the heart of Good Hart, right here in the big metropolis of all three businesses that we have.
I know, so, yeah, I was gonna say there's three buildings in Good Hart, four?
Yeah, well, there's three buildings and then there's the crepe cart, so.
Oh, okay.
This is it, this is the big burb. So people will come in and they'll ask, where's the rest of Good Hart? You're in the middle of it, this is it. But it attracts a lot of people because of the charm. We try to keep it that low key and.
What's such a pleasant surprise? You're going along the Tunnel of Trees and all of a sudden they open up and there's this little sleepy village.
They call us the middle of nowhere.
Yeah, exactly. So. That's perfect. But you've got the general store, right?
Yep, general store, Primitive Images and A Studio, and then the crepe cart sandwiched in between.
And that's where Cece's brother Matt comes in. He took a French classic, filled it with fresh Michigan ingredients, and brought this micro restaurant to this micro town for all to enjoy.
Well, I thought UTR headquarters was small. It's tight quarters.
I did it alone for the first year, and then my son and I did it, and we couldn't be next to each other for very long without. So we took turns.
Well, I can't believe the response to this thing.
It's
I
amazing.
Mean, since we've been here, people have been lined up to get crepes. It was an accidental, incredibly great idea.
The idea was it was going to be a lot of fun, and it is.
Bonjour.
Bonjour, monsieur. Ça va?
Comme ça. So you enjoyed your crepe?
I love my crepe.
My crepe was phenomenal.
Fantastic. Good place to stop.
Say it in French.
Le crepe est phenomenal.
So you went from never having made a crepe to all of a sudden owning a crepe cart.
Correct. Took 3 months.
How did you learn?
Trial and error, a lot of it.
A lot of error.
And now it's easy.
But the other thing I noticed is the crepes, the ingredients look really incredible.
People love the fact that they can watch us literally cutting up strawberries, pears, whatever, while we're making it. Because they know then that it's fresh.
I love stories like yours. It's like you see something, you go, I can totally do that, and then you totally do it.
I don't know how, but it worked out pretty well.
You figured it out. We didn't know how to do a TV show. We just figured it out.
So next time you're driving through the Tunnel of Trees, if you can manage not to blink, stop, shop, and roll up into Good Hart. I'm sure Matt would be happy to roll up a crepe for you. What's worth giving up electricity, running water, and a bathroom for? Wilderness State Park, that's what. You heard right, the UTR crew is gonna rough it. And we don't even mind because we're about to experience one of Michigan's most beautiful places to connect with nature. Wilderness State Park is one of those iconic parks that almost defines Michigan wilderness. It's the natural world at its best, and it's here for all of us to support and enjoy. The park is only 10 miles west of Mackinaw City, almost in the shadows of the Mackinaw Bridge. And park supervisor Burr Mitchell was more than happy to share this paradise with us.
Look mighty serious, Burr.
Tell me, how far can you see out here? What are those islands?
It's actually the UP.
Oh, that's the UP?
Yeah.
Okay, I thought that was a big island. Absolutely incredible. How much shoreline do you have at this park?
26 miles.
26 miles of shoreline?
Including the islands, the circumference going around the islands.
What are some of the interesting facts people might not know about this park?
Well, during World War II, they used the point out there as a bombing target.
In World War II, they were actually shooting...
Dropping bombs out there. In fact, that's why it's such good bass fishery out in some of that section out there, because the bomb craters on the bottom of the lake, the smallmouth coming in and spawn.
Interesting. Now, the cabin we're staying in, it's rustic camping, right? Yeah. Rustic.
Yeah. It's like tent camping without a tent.
And you also have that, a campground that's right on the water?
Lakeshore campground sits right on the water. We have 150 modern sites in that campground. And then on the other side of the road, we have the Pines campground with another 100 sites.
If there's one thing you'd like to tell people about the Michigan State Parks, what would it be?
That for $11, the residents of the state of Michigan can visit any of the state parks. That's what the recreation passport costs. You check that box, and that's the money that we use to maintain these facilities and keep these lands as pristine as what they are.
Well, I bought two of them this year, just so you know. Mm-hmm. Well, actually, I bought three of them. I bought one for my son's car, too. So, but whether we use them or not, it's a good cause. I mean, anything to help support the parks.
Well, we appreciate that.
Since we're at the park to do some exploring, Burr hooked us up with Leah Kilpatrick. She's the park explorer guide, and all this nature is just second nature to her. So how long have you been at the park?
This is actually my seventh season, and it flies by.
Oh, I'll bet. Well, because you're having so much fun. I mean, what a great place to work.
It is beautiful.
How did you get into being, you know, a park person?
Well, I didn't. Actually, until I started working here, I never visited Wilderness State Park, and I'm only 15 minutes away. But I found out about it online, and I came to Wilderness, and I got hired in, and it's been one of the best experiences thus far.
Now, right now, we're at the southern end of the park.
Right, yes.
Where the dunes are, which, by the way, are incredible.
Oh, aren't they gorgeous?
Yeah, when you stand up there, so you've got dunes on one side, then you've mm-hmm. got the lake on the other side.
Mm-hmm.
And the point out here that we're seeing.
Right.
That's where we were, that's where our cabin is.
Yep, your cabin's just on the other side. That's actually Waukesha's Point out there, and you have a few islands. Mm-hmm. And all the cabins that you guys are at face the opposite side. But yeah, that's the point where they do all the bass fishing out that way, too.
Absolutely incredible. So you can camp on the beach here.
Right.
You've got dunes here.
Mm-hmm.
Cabins here. Bigfoot never comes here, does he?
Actually, somebody claimed they saw him a few years back.
Well, it's probably one of our crew. But how big is this park total?
We're actually at over 10,500 acres. That's in the park. It is. It's massive. You couldn't even begin to explore the park just within a week visit. There's spots that people haven't been to in probably over 30 years.
Well, it was a half-hour drive just from the north side where our cabin is to where we are now.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And that shows you the size of the park.
Right.
And this beach is, it's massive. It's huge. And there's almost nobody here. That's right. What I love about it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is a premier beach. People come from all over the state to visit Sturgeon Bay.
What's the most rewarding thing for you about doing this?
Well, I do all the nature programs. So the biggest thing for me is when I'm doing a nature program and I'm out there with kids, seeing that light bulb. When you show them a plant they've never seen before, or they catch their first frog, and you see that light bulb go off, because it's up to them to protect these natural resources. So just seeing that spark is really what makes this job worthwhile for me.
Were you always into nature, or did you come here and it just hit you?
Now, when I was three, I was the kid that was stuffing earthworms in my pockets, and Mom would do the laundry, pull the worms out with the clean clothes. So it's always just intrigued me, and I love it. So I love getting out in the trails every day, finding something new, identifying new plants, so.
You work in paradise.
Oh, I agree with you, 100%.
Mind if we stay?
Oh, as long as you want, you got your passport.
I honestly don't remember the last time I breathed air this clean or stared at the lake for so long. This really was a great way to end our Tips of the Fingers adventure. We relaxed on Lake Huron, ate like Italians, flew like birds, dined with a ghost, caught a good crepe, and wandered the wilderness. After all that, I give the top of Michigan's mitten a definite high five. Congratulations, you just finished watching the best TV show in the world. At least as far as we think. Anyway, if you want more information about all the great places we go on the program, just go to our website. You can watch past episodes, you can tell us where you want us to go next, use our visitor information guide, jump to our Facebook page, and even buy a hat like mine. So just go to utrmichigan.com. That's utrmichigan.com. I'd go right now.
or now.
Under the Radar Michigan is brought to you in part by the Michigan State Housing Development Authority, investing in people, places, and partnerships to help transform Michigan and the Michigan economy. In cities, towns, and neighborhoods, people are building better places to live and better communities. Also by Big B Coffee, celebrating 18 years as a Michigan company. Gift cards, mugs, and coffee by the pound available in store and online. Franchise info available at biggby.com.